They perform with Ensemble Español, which is a big group in Chicago and then throughout the Chicago area. So thank you so much for coming and partaking. We don't charge admission, but there is a basket by the door there for donations, so we very much appreciate donations so that we can have more concerts. So. With that, I'll turn it over to you guys.
Thank you. Just in case you were wondering, or if you're not familiar with flamenco, those first couple pieces we played, the first piece was called a bulería, and it's a style within flamenco that we do. It's more, a little bit more on the improvised side and have fun with it and kind of take turns taking the spotlight. That was called a bulería. The last piece we just did that Luis danced in was called the sevillanas, and it's actually more on the folkloric side from Spain. It's not as much from the flamenco side, but they've incorporated into the flamenco shows and into the flamenco dances, so it's got a little bit of a fusion with the techniques. So that was that last piece, and this next one features Kai on the vocals.
Ole. Ole.
Just the bueno.
Pasa.
On, thank you. the style within flamenco is called colombiana, and there's a bunch of styles within flamenco that were influenced from South America or Central America, and that was one of the ones that were had a little bit more of a South American influence to it, so from the travelers back then. So the next piece we're doing for you guys is a farruca. Do you want to say anything about that?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
So a farruca is a very serious dance in flamenco. It was originally, it started from the men, but now in our time, the women have really come up with the movement and they have really, let's say, they pioneered it to cause it to be at a whole nother spectrum of dance. So the guys created it, but the girls carried it away. But it's a very, very manly, very, very, what's the word? Very manly,
masculine
dance. But and if the woman now does it, they wear the men's suits. They wear the men's full suit. And back then, women, it was kind of taboo for a woman to wear pants. But the women also wear high-waisted pants with the men, and then that's how the dance started. But and that's a little bit of farruca. It's a very serious dance. It's a dance done by fours, like the little tangos that we were practicing in the class. It has the same compás structure. And I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you.
So part of being flamenco is very participatory with the audience. So if you go to, if you've ever been to a flamenco show, not as much here, but more so in Spain, you'll hear a lot of shouting and participating from the audience. Just like we would maybe do here when you see like, the guitar solo, that's like, you're like, woo, like, you know, but we just say woo, we woo, or we clap, yeah. But, you know, in flamenco, we ole, or we say, you know, other things like SOS, like, yeah, that's it, like, get it, you know. So we kind of, people say it out loud, and it's totally acceptable. So sometimes if you go to a flamenco show here, and there's people that know flamenco in the audience, and you know, some will be like, "Ole!" They're like, "Shh!" I'm like, "No, no, it's okay." They want, you know, the artists. It's like an affirmation of, you know, they you guys like what we're doing, so and you guys want to do it, right? Like you feel like you want to join in. So it's very acceptable to say "Ole" if you feel it. Only if you feel it, though. Don't, you know? Don't fake "Ole." No fake "Ole" is allowed. Don't fake it. It's totally acceptable. We won't be mad. So we're gonna do a rumba, which is a lot of people are introduced to flamenco through this form. It's a very festive party form, and a lot of the singing it's kind of like you take a lot of choruses. Flamenco singing is interesting in that way. Songs, their songs are not like, you know, you'll learn one song like "Mary Had a Little Lamb." It's always gonna have the same verses, right? But flamenco is not like that. You learn a bunch of different verses, and different parts in Spain and regions have different types of melodies that go with these verses. And then you find some cool choruses that you like, and you kind of lump them together and you make your own song. So the guitarist really has to know a lot of these melodies from the different regions. Not so much the words, but just the melodies. And also, it's very subtle what we're doing that you might not pick up on. We're kind of signaling each other with our bodies and our hands, and that's all part of it, like saying, like, give me a break here, or give me a stop. Musically, it's kind of like we conduct each other in a way that way. That's a little flamenco secret that I'm gonna share with you. So feel free to ole. I mean, I don't know if we want to teach a little vamos or not, or, you know. So this pattern for the rhythm, for the hand clapping, there's very complex rhythms, like the 6-count rhythms or 12-count rhythms. This is a pretty easy one. This is a 4-count rhythm. So I'll show it to you, and if you feel like you want to join in on this next piece, feel free. Okay, so basically, let's give me a little rhythm. So that's a pretty rhythm that we're used to in this part, right? So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the only beat you don't clap on is 1, which is weird. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So you open on 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Is like, it's called sordas, and it's kind of like we cup our hands. Keep going. So it sounds like, see how soft? It's like a softer, like, it's called sordas, muted. Right? And then we do the claras, which is the clear sound. And we take, you know, 3 fingers, and we find a nice little sweet spot right in the middle. And you give a nice little crisp. I'm gonna do it this way. Another, if you want to stick with this rhythm, that's fine, but if you want to get fancy, you can do... Right? So some of you guys can do this, and some guys can do... If you want to get really fancy, do the counter rhythm. Maybe the next show. Just practice that. So we'll do a little rumba. You guys feel free if you want to clap along with us. A little faster.
enough time resting, so
he's
ready for the next dance.
Alegrías de Cádiz is a dance originally from Cádiz in Spain, Cádiz, Spain. It's a dance that really reflects the happiness and the joy. Alegría is joy in English. So when you see a dance, this is a very happy dance, very always like fruity, cheesy, happy, enjoying life by the beach in Cádiz. That's what I really want you guys to see. Imagine the palm trees, imagine the rocky beach.
The ocean.
Remember the ocean. That's Alegría. I hope you guys enjoy it. Vamos.
Thank you.
He works hard for the money. Well, thank you so much for having us out. You treated us so well, and we ate so well, and you are wonderful. We appreciate that as artists, we really do. We'd be surprised. But it's really nice to come into a new place and to have people welcome us so nicely. We really do appreciate that. And we're gonna close with a little, another party form, which is a tangos, flamenco tangos, just a very short, piece, and I know we have some people that took the dance workshop here still. We're dance. Don't worry, we're not gonna make you. We're not gonna put you on the spotlight. I feel so inclined. It's okay. We're just gonna do a short little tangos flamenco for you, and thank you so much for having us.
Yeah, thank you to everyone who came out to the guitar workshop as well. I hope you take something with you and. Hope you got to see a little bit of it in action and recognize some of the techniques we talked about. So,
wonderful.
Same goes here for my dance class. Love you guys. It's always in here. That's it. Steps are everywhere. Here's not everywhere. Ale. Thank you. Looks like I need it, don't I?
Feel free to dance, really, no pressure. Thank you.
time for two more small ones. If that works out for you guys. Choice on what to finish for you guys. Yeah, something light or something a little bit more intense, but we'll go with the fun stuff. Just to end on a light night note. once again for coming out. You were a great crowd, and thanks, Anne, for for setting it all up, putting it all together.
We'll definitely come
back. If anybody wants to look us up or wants some information, in case you're ever in the Chicagoland area, you're welcome to grab some info or a card or look us up online. And also have some instrumental CDs for sale. So we'd love to see you again. So thank you again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And your dancing.
Oh, thank you, sir.
What do you think, Randy?
Oh, they were phenomenal.
Wasn't that great?
I think they were, they're genius.
I agree.
The dancer and the guitarist.
Oh, that dancer.
Like nothing I've ever seen before.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Here in Bean Blossom, Indiana.
Who'd have thought?
What more could you ask for?
Who'd have thought?
Thanks for taping this, Jeff.
Oh, you bet. You bet. We'll see you at 11.
Here for Log Cabin Lodge.
Hey, Lost Cabin Lodge.